I'm Fatima.
And I'm Sean.
And we are
Powerful Creators.
Episode number 11 of Powerful Creators podcast. Hey, Sean.
Hey, Fatima.
So today we are bringing this very cool word, persistence. Right, Sean?
I love it, Fatima. The power of persistence.
Yes. So let's start. What is persistence, Sean?
Persistence is not giving up, Fatima. In my mind, persistence is the opportunity to continue even when you're not feeling super awesome about something.
Wow. I love that. And I was reading Napoleon Hill, and he was saying he has a full chapter just about persistence, especially because this is one of the laws of success of Napoleon Hill Think and Grow Rich book. And he says that persistence is a state of mind, therefore it can be cultivated. And I like that.
That's so true, Fatima. Persistence is a state of mind, so it can be cultivated. I don't think we're born with persistence. I think it's something that we do cultivate. And I think that if we're passionate about something, it's easier to cultivate and it's easier to persist.
Yeah, I was also researching on the internet about the meaning of this word through dictionaries or other authors. And I read that it's also defined as a voluntary continuation of a goal, direction, action, in spite of obstacles, difficulties, or discouragement. And you know that I really don't like to call them obstacles or something like that. But I like the way they say that is a voluntary continuation of a goal, direction, action. Because for me, when we have a defined goal, and this is something that we are going to speak in the next episode about decisions, taking decisions and having clear visions. When you have that clear vision, it's really important to have this persistence, especially because in the last episode, we talked about failure. And if you don't keep trying, keep working, keep moving forward, you just don't get there. So you really need persistence. This is the secret ingredient for success.
I agree with you 100%, Fatima. This persistence is definitely the secret ingredient to getting from where you are to where you want to be. And so if we review the previous episode, we talked about how to change failure to feedback. It's a whole lot easier to be persistent whenever you're having feedback encourage you. So we turn something that's not super awesome into something that motivates us. And when we are motivated, we are more naturally persistent. If we could be naturally more persistent, then whatever we're looking for, our outcomes are going to be that much easier and funner to achieve.
Yes. And it's so interesting how these two words are connected, the episode from today and the episode from last time, because if you don't really move forward, if you don't try, if you don't do any action, you are not being persistent. So what takes you to the next step is believing that you can do it, even if you kind of fail, and we don't really want to call it fail. If you just, if it doesn't work out at that point, you keep yourself persistent and you will get there.
With persistence, Fatima, you're naturally able to go through the numbers of experiences and I won't say techniques, but experiences and times to be able to move through something, to gather enough times. If you have feedback that's not positive, but you know whenever you try again, there's a very good possibility then the next few outcomes, that's the word I was looking for, outcomes from events that you want to do, then you know that persistence will naturally build up. a lot of people really enjoy solving puzzles. And so they know that whatever they're doing is considered a puzzle that needs to be put together. And the curiosity and the motivation to solve drives us and helps us be persistent. So if we could reframe some of the things that are not where we want and help to become more naturally persistent, then the process becomes a lot funner. And even though the feedback we're receiving is not what we want, we're still enjoying ourselves through the process. We're still lifting our energy. We're still motivating ourselves without even thinking about it.
Yes, and we are allowing ourselves to get there because there is no substitute for persistence. There are so many people that are talented, that are so gifted, but if they don't have persistence, they won't get there, right?
Exactly. If you love what you're doing, it's easier to be persistent. But sometimes, like raking leaves out of the yard is just not that fun. But you have to be persistent and get it done.
Yes. And this is why I love, we are speaking about people, I love stories. And we know so many stories from our friends and from ourselves in which we were persistent and we were able to get the things that we wanted. But there are also many, many people that everybody knows, like Elvis Presley, for example. He was fired after his first performance. His manager told him many words that are not really good and that could made him quit from his dream of singing. Also, Steven Spielberg, he got rejected from the film school 3 times, as I read. We have more people, right, Sean?
Absolutely, Fatima. And let's dive a little deeper. Elvis and Steven Spielberg, their passion was so great for what they were doing. Persistence was almost like a friend walking arm in arm. If Elvis wasn't passionate about music and rock and roll, then he would have said, no big deal. I'll go over here and try farming or point or one of 100, you know, different things that he could have done. Steven Spielberg was so passionate about movies and movie making and putting his unique fingerprint on movies and the movie business that you don't hear the word no. You're automatically persistent. When you're passionate about a topic, when you're passionate about something, it's easier to be persistent. So I would invite, number one, I would invite all of our audience to share some stories with us. Do reach out to us on our social media sites and share with us how persistence has helped you in an endeavor. And also how being a little more persistent would help you in future endeavors.
Yes, especially if you have a situation in which you feel that you have your huge passion there, no matter the condition in which you are, just go ahead. Just like Joanne Rowling, the author of Harry Potter's books, she was jobless, she was divorced, she was without any money, with a dependent child, and she was rejected by 12 major publishers. And she just persisted. No matter the condition she was, she believed it was her passion. And then she had this small publisher giving her a tiny advance of some money, and they published some copies, and suddenly she was selling millions. So if it's your passion, believe on it and be persistent. Also, just like, and that's interesting that you are speaking about passion, Sean, because we also have Michael Jordan that was cut from his high school basketball team. He was told that he wasn't good, and see in which great basketball player he became. Jim Carrey the same. He was booed off stage at his first comic stand-up, and today he's one of the most famous comedians. We have so many people that if they had quit at that time, in the very first time, they wouldn't be where they are right now.
Fatima, I would even go further and say that everyone that has created results in a big way, if they had stopped on the very first failure, the very first feedback that didn't agree, the very first no, none of the things that we enjoy today would be here. All of the scientific discoveries, all of the people in our lives and the things and the products and all the things that we enjoy, very little would be here if those people behind those products and services and people said no or quit and were not persistent. Persistence is something that is very important. I'm thinking about Thomas Edison, the famous inventor that invented all the many electrical gadgets and wizardry things that we still use today. If he would have given up, we wouldn't have the light bulb. And he had tried many thousands of times. And there was one time there was someone interviewed him and then they said, what would you do if you hadn't invented a light bulb? And he said, Edison said to the interviewer, I wouldn't be talking to you right now. I'd still be in my laboratory. That's persistence.
Yes. So how can someone develop persistence today? And we have some tips here, right, Sean?
Absolutely, Fatima. I would say the first thing to develop persistence is to reframe how you're thinking and also to find your passion. We're not all going to be Elvis. We're not all going to be awesome singers, but we find our passion. Some people might be good salespeople. Some people might be sculptors. Some people might be good traders. Some people might be good homemakers. There's many things. When you're passionate about something, it's easy to reframe what's happened, and it's easy to invest what you've reframed into better feeling emotions. And those better feeling emotions will lift you into an easy state of persistence.
Yes, I love the way you used the expression, what makes your heart sing. You always asked me this many times in the beginning when I started being mentoring by you, Sean. You were always asking me, what makes your heart sing? And this is amazing. Also, in case you need to develop persistence in a task that is not your passion, let's put that situation also, I would suggest to notice your thoughts about that task that you need to do and make a conscious effort to dismiss those thoughts. What is exactly making you to not keep going with that task, and how can you overcome that? How can you make it fun? How can you make it more interesting? How can that have a really great side and make you wiser, make you more, I would say, in a growth process?
I have a couple of ideas, Fatima, to share some thoughts on your question. One of the first things that I would say is that if we're tasked with an activity that we don't really like, oftentimes, for instance, I'll go back to the example of raking the leaves from the yard. If you really don't like raking leaves from the yard and you see them piling up and piling up and no amount of persistence is motivating you to go pick those leaves up, hire somebody, outsource those things that you can outsource that doesn't make your heart sing. But there's also another way to go about that. What if you have the opportunity of raking your yard? What if you reframe that and looked at it as a more of a meditative event where through the process of the raking, you're in the sunshine, you're allowing the rhythm of the moving the rake over the yard to be very meditative and more of an opportunity to relax and a more opportunity to clear your mind and be in a meditative state, if you will. Great time to think while you're doing yard work. But if it's something you hate, don't force yourself to do it. Find help with it and get some outside help. Because someone out there loves raking leaves. And if you connect the person that's passionate about the job that needs to be done, magic happens.
Exactly. I love that. I love how we can delegate to keep focused on what we want. At the same time, the developing persistence on some tasks, maybe they just mean by rephrasing, as you said, and trying to make it funny, trying to make it different. I was thinking now, for example, I know that some people don't like to travel, but they have to travel. So what you can do is maybe listening to Powerful Creators podcast during that travel. Maybe you can listen to any song that you love, some of our meditations, for example. So just make it funny and try to see always the good side of everything and how you can get to the end. Always look to where you want to go. And when you see the result, the outcome, you enjoy even more the process.
Absolutely, Fatima. That's a really, you bring some really, really great points up there. And I would invite the audience, anyone that is raking the leaves from your yard should definitely be listening to some of your wonderful music and meditation. So absolutely. And you are such an amazing musician and it's just, everybody should get to know your music. And I invite everybody to do that. Putting it all together and reframing and meditating, referencing something that you like to do, those are so powerful. And it takes the mundane task into something that, even if it's not super exciting, we get the job done and we have a good experience doing it. And we move on to that thing that really does make our hearts sing.
Thank you very much for your words, Sean. And I have to share that you are a really great mentor and you taught me a lot about persistence. Some of the other things I learned with you about this topic is to take inspired action right away, for example, and also to create a friendly alliance or mastermind with one or more persons who would encourage me to follow through my plan or purpose. And we did create this mastermind and it really helped me keeping focused, keeping persistent and achieving so many great things that I achieved in the last years.
Exactly, Fatima. The Mastermind Alliance is one of the most profound things that I ever learned in my life. And that's saying a lot. And I thank Napoleon Hill every day for bringing that to light. Without the Mastermind Alliance, many of the things and many of the things we enjoy to the people that we enjoy them with wouldn't be nearly as rewarding, nearly as fulfilling. And one mind plus one mind, one plus one is not two when it comes to a Mastermind Alliance. Two minds together are multiples. And it's really amazing. You're an amazing person to be in a Mastermind Alliance with. We're doing wonderful work. We're sharing our mission with the world. And that definitely makes my heart sing.
Thank you so much, Sean. I share the same words. I also have another tip that I was reading this week from Kim Kiyosaki's book. She, on the Rich Woman book, she was saying how important it is to not give attention to people that don't have the experiences as we have, but they are always giving advice. So I would say close your mind against any negative or discouraging influences, especially relatives, friends, or acquaintances that don't have any experience on achieving what you want to achieve. So, for example, if you have the dream of a business, a specific business, and you have someone saying that you should not do it because it's hard, because it's complicated, because whatever it is, just take look if that person has already any successful business. If she doesn't, why are you giving attention to someone that doesn't have what you want to achieve? That won't be wise. Instead of that, maybe you should talk with someone that already has a successful business, and maybe that person will help through your persistence on getting a successful business. Not just a business, but a successful one.
So Fatima, it sounds like what you're really describing there is you have to be careful with who you're surrounding yourself with. You have to be careful with who you take advice from. And you should qualify the person before you let their advice get inside your brain. Is that right?
Yes, yes, also. That really influences your persistence. I can see that some people quit fast because they have a boyfriend or a father or a mom or a colleague or a best friend that doesn't encourage, doesn't empower. And sometimes it's like having a cup of water. If you put water of empowerment in that cup, it will feel in a positive way. But if you take out that water with some people that are always taking that water out and don't encourage you, you will lose the persistence. You will lose the water inside that cup.
The power of association is so important, Fatima. And you just made a really good descriptive picture and story. There's always someone, if you allow them to drain the water out of your cup, and if the water in your cup is the same thing as your mental energy, then that's a really great analogy that you put there. If someone's draining the water out of your cup, if somebody's putting heavy energy in your activities, then you have to reevaluate that association. And if you really want to excel, you have to surround yourself with positive, like-minded people.
Yes. So for today's episode, we have these takeaways. Surround yourself with the best, encourage and empowering people you can, especially with people that already achieved what you want to achieve. Create a friendly alliance or mastermind with someone or one or more people that will encourage you. Take inspired action right away. Create a plan that is expressed in a continuous action, and that can be backed up by burning desire for its fulfillment. And notice your thoughts. Remember how important it is to keep believing, to keep doing positive affirmations, to keep taking inspired action, and to keep your alignment and ability to allow anything to come to you.
When you have that wonderful mastermind, Fatima, each person lifts the other, and persistence then is almost easy. Is it possible? Could we reframe persistence as something that takes effort? Could we reframe that as something that is effortless? Yes, I believe we can. When you have those people around you that are lifting you, that encourage you, that never let you give up, if they're a little bit down one day, you're up and you lift them back. And if the other is down a little bit or has something they're working on, you offer help and encouragement. So having those people around you make persistence fun and easy. And that's how I'd like to invite our listeners to don't let persistence be a heavy cloud. Let persistence be part of the natural lifting. And when you're there, everything else is a whole lot easier to manifest. it's easier to have that point of focus, and it's easier for things to come into point of focus. It's easier to cross paths with the people you need to cross paths with. It's easier to get your yard rate. It's easier to get anything done you need to be done.
Yes. So the question today is, do you want to embrace persistence? And if the answer is yes, way to go. If the answer is, let's say that you need to hear our next episode about decisions. Right, Sean?
Decisions. decisions, Fatima.
Yes, so don't lose our next episode about decisions, taking decision, being a decision maker. It will be next Tuesday. And we will be back. Right, Sean?
I'm counting the minutes. So awesome, Fatima. Wonderful.
Yes. Share your comments of today's episode on the YouTube channel, the IGTV, the Spotify, any platform that we have. Remember that we have these episodes in Portuguese on the YouTube with subtitles. And we are here, right, Sean, next Tuesday.
Absolutely. Come join us. We look forward to having you.
Talk soon.
Talk soon.
Can I share this on the podcast? I don't know.
Sure. Maybe we do like an outtakes video, like a bloopers.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you can.
You deserve.
And you are a powerful creator.